Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. In this video, we're going to take a look at how to build this explosion of lines. Now let's first take a look at how not to do it because it doesn't work, and that's with a scatter brush. So if we create this with a scatter brush, it's just not possible to control it. So we need to do it differently. We're going to start with the lines. So I'm going to start with the line, and let's just undo that because I'm going to start from the center. And then let's use the rotate tool and click here, press the Alt key and click. And then let's enter 5 degrees. Take a look at the preview, that's fine, and copy. And then let's just object transform, transform again, or Command D, Control D on Windows. So let's just do that. And I'm just going to hold it down and Illustrator does its thing like so. So the next thing is we want to have these different random lengths on the outside. Going to select them, and then let's go to Object, Transform, Transform Each. And there we're going to input horizontal and vertical scale, like so, 150 degrees, or if you want more, then you enter more. And of course you check random and the center origin point. So like so. And if you don't like it, just turn on random off and on again, and it will create a different look every time you click that. So let's go to OK. That's great. But in the center, they all start from different points because they got scaled. And that's what we can't have. So we want this in the center. So in the center, we now need a circle. And you can create the circle from that center point using the ellipse tool and just check out the smart guides to find the point where they intersect, or just create that starting from the point where it's just dense, because it actually doesn't really matter that much. So press the Alt key and make that circle like so. And now we're going to apply a fill to it and no stroke, just like so. And there's the fill. And of course it needs to be irregular. So to get that effect, Distort and Transform, roughen. And in here, make it a large size, like so, and see that you adjust the detail, maybe like that. And again, you can adjust that until you like it. And we need to expand that. So, Object, Expand Appearance, we need that as a shape. And now we need to, you know, punch this. So we need to actually cut these lines. So in order to do that, we are going to use pathfinders. But pathfinders only work nicely with fills. These have strokes. So we're going to select all, and then let's zoom in and deselect the orange thing and then switch fill and stroke like so. And now select all again and go to Window and Pathfinder, and we use the outline one like so. And the nice thing is now we need to delete things and we don't want to select them manually. So what we can do, because we had an orange shape in the center, this is what's left over. So let's first ungroup this. And now select one of these orange lines and go to select same and then stroke color and just hit delete. So now we've got the result. Next thing, select all of them. They've already got a stroke. And let's set this to 20 points or the like and go to the width profiles. And now we see Illustrator has somehow switched the direction of some of those paths, which is not so nice. First of all, we need to set this cap to the straight version, like so, and let's make this thicker so we can find the ones that we can't have. There are some short ones in here that don't work so well. Let's delete these. We need to find them like so. And there's yet another one. And then we need to select those that have the wrong direction. And let's see that we don't need to click them, but with some it's impossible to do it differently. So like so, and then go to the stroke panel and change the direction and do this to all of them where needed. So like so, and these, and again switch them, which is somehow not possible for all of them. So this is somewhat a little tedious to do. Let's select this one again and switch it. And then let's select these, switch them, and these as well. And then let's go to the final ones in here and switch them. And then there are these. Okay, nice. So some are still left, like so. The next thing is some of them need to have a different weight. And again, this should be randomized. So what you can do is use scripts. There are some randomization scripts, but also you can use the lasso tool and do a selection such as this. And when you have that, then go to the stroke panel and change this. Let's set this thicker and make another selection, and you get the idea of how you can finally get this randomized like so. So this is how you can get this starburst kind of design. I'm going to link some randomization scripts in the info for this video, and yeah, have fun creating this.